I don't think there's still enough sensitivity about the importance of snow on our planet, on our life, and on our economy. The idea of climate change impacting Olympics is there. We are already facing a lot of the implications.
In Vancouver in 2010, they were trucking in snow, helicoptering it up onto the half pipe and race courses. Sochi in 2014, they actually put 500,000 cubic meters of snow from the previous season into a giant pile, covered it with tarps, and then used artificial snow to make 150% of the snow they were going to need. Even in Pyeongchang in South Korea in 2018, that was 98% artificial snow.
What happens when you hold a Winter Olympics in a metropolis with hardly any naturally occurring snow? We will soon find out, and that is tonight's By the Numbers.
Beijing has this dubious distinction of the first Winter Olympics to be performed on artificial snow. I think they're the first to actually admit it and claim it and possibly even be somewhat proud of the engineering feat. Man-made snow is made with high-pressure pumps and snow guns and is ironically the most energy-intense operation on the mountain and the most water-intense. So snowmaking is a band-aid. What you're looking at is the future of winter.
The snow cover has been reducing and shrinking over the past decades. Most importantly, snow is falling later, is going away sooner, and is melting much faster. Snow and ice are crucial components of the ecosystem of our planet and for our well-being and for our society. From a energy point of view, the bright snow and ice surfaces reflect more solar radiation in the sky, keeping our planet cool. They also are a huge buffer of fresh water.
You know, at a certain point, you have to think, when are we going to stop putting blankets on the glaciers at Zermatt and making artificial snow at every single ski resort across the U.S. and look at the big picture and figure out why this is happening and what we need to do and how we need to change to kind of get things back on track.
We really have to look at the climate, in this case a snow problem, as a holistic societal, economic, and geography problem. Colombia's research, especially within the climate school, Lamont, we are really at the front of research in this regard.